أما بعد فقد قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتاب العزيز بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ولا تحسبن الذين قتلوا في سبيل الله أمواتا بل أحياء عند ربهم يرزقون فرحين بما آتاهم الله من فضله ويستبشرون بالذين لم يلحقوا بهم من خلفهم ألا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أوذيت في الله ما لم يؤذ أحد وخفت في الله ما لم يخف أحد أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. The only fear that is required and demanded to have is the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إنما ذلكم الشيطان يخوف أولياء. Allah says very clearly in Ali Imran, this is the plots of the devil. They are trying to build fear in the friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلَا تَخَافُوهُمْ وَخَافُونِي إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. Don't fear anyone. No one is worthy of fear except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَالَ لَا تَخَافَا. Straightforward. God said, remove all fear. To live in the concept, in the realm of fear, really, it demobilizes us. It handicaps us. Our children, they can't follow religion. They can't be proud to be Muslims. So the first thing I want to do is to recognize there is pain in the world. We mourn what the casualties and the people who are killed in New Zealand, our Muslim brothers and sisters. But the most important thing here, brothers and sisters, is that we can't live under fear. We can't live under the impression that we're always under attack. There's always good and love and peace and compassion, much more you will find in society than you'll find in people who hate Islam and people who hate people of religion and peace. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to Prophet Musa, قَالَ لَا تَخَافَا. Why? إِنَّنِي مَعْكُمَا. I'm with you. I'm with you all the way. إِنَّنِي مَعْكُمَا أَسْمَعُ وَأَرَى. I'm listening to you. I hear you. I'm watching you. وَاصْبَرْ لِحُكْمِ رَبِّكَ. أَصْبِرْ لِحُكْمِ رَبِّكَ فَإِنَّكَ بِأَعْيُنِنَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the Prophet in conclusion, O Muhammad, Surah Najm, listen. فَإِنَّكَ بِأَعْيُنِنَا. You're with us. We're not letting you alone. We're not letting you to be attacked from the world and you're not going to be recognized. فَإِنَّكَ بِأَعْيُنِنَا. وَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ حِينَ تَقُوْ. And then you recognize and you praise your Lord. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says very beautifully, in Surah Hijr, فَاصْدَعْ بِمَا تُؤْمَرْ. Just the fact that, you know, the concept of living under fear, Allah says, فَاصْدَعْ بِمَا تُؤْمَرْ. You stay consistent on your practice, your religion, Islam, the cause that you've been sent for. We're not going to shy away from who we are. We are the people who follow Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we believe this is the most peaceful way of life. فَاصْدَعْ بِمَا تُؤْمَرْ. And stay consistent on what you've been ordered by Allah. وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. Ignore this, the slander against Islam. Of course, you have to calculately combat it academically. وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. إِنَّا كَفَيْنَاكَ الْمُسْتَهْزِئِينَ. We are sufficient for you. الَّذِينَ يَجْعَلُونَ مَعَ اللَّهِ لَنْ آخَرَ فَسَوْفَ يَعْلَمُونَ. And Allah says this ayah right here. وَلَقَدْ نَعْلَمُ أَنَّكَ يَضِيقُ صَدْرُكَ بِمَا يَقُولُونَ. We know what you're going through. Brothers and sisters, the main message that I want to share with you, and the last two messages, is that we will not live under the state of fear. And number two, to comfort the situation, is that we live through the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the difficulties he went through. And that last but not the least, brothers and sisters, it is important that as parents, as guardians, we sit down with our children and let them know what's happening, because they're going to read it online. They already know more than you probably. They're talking about it. They're reading about it. They're watching these things. We will make sure that every innocent child and human, man and woman, who has been innocently killed in this attack, we live their legacy. So brothers and sisters, we pray for these shuhada. Allahumma ighfir lahum ya rabbal alameen. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to elevate their statuses. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give their parents, their children, their families, their wives, their husbands, sabr. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give that community strength in New Zealand. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to unite the Muslim community. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to remove all hardships and difficulties upon the Muslims, whether they're in America or Australia or New Zealand, in Europe or in Palestine. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help the Muslim sisters and brothers across the world who are going through difficulties.